The fall was taken by Chief Petty Officer Mina Hassan in Urbit, Jordan, 48 hours before he was shot by Master Chief Hayes. There is a gun tucked into Nafal's waistband on the left side. The grip is consistent with an M1951 Beretta.
The gun described by Master Chief Hayes.
Yes, ma'am, the very same.
What matters is the evidence. A video of Master Chief Hayes shooting an unarmed man without provocation. The defense provided a partial image of the grip of a pistol from 2 days before the killing. This is purely circumstantial and cannot put a gun in the victim's hand at the time of his death. The government asks that you find the accused guilty as charged.
Lieutenant Commander Williams.
You've seen the photo of the gun. You've heard the testimony of the sailors who stood alongside Master Chief Hayes, who applaud his good standing and honorable reputation. And you've heard the sworn statement of Master Chief Hayes himself. Master Chief Hayes, in many ways, is the embodiment of the War on Terror. For over 20 years, he's run into the fire for his country. While the prosecution has gone to great lengths to portray Master Chief Hayes as a killer, I've learned, and I hope you have too, that Master Chief Hayes doesn't do his job to shoot the enemy in front of him. He does it to protect the people behind him. Not just his teammates, but his countrymen. And despite all he's sacrificed and the deep personal price he's paid, Master Chief Hayes has never asked for anything in return. So I'll ask for him. If you're willing to trust him with your freedom, please also trust his word.
Has the panel reached a verdict?
Yes, we have, Your Honor. We find the defendant, Master Chief Jason M. Hayes, not guilty.
Thank you.
It was my honor, Master Chief.